And welcome back. This is your man Warrior for another patron roster review. This is Colonel 32. Now, I always wondered why we pronounce in America or in English Colonel, the C-O-L-O-N-E-L. I don't know why we say that's Colonel, but that is what in fact it is. Colonel 32, he is from the Guild of Star Wars. Star Wars, what's happening? Now, Colonel 32 has not given me a ton of guidance. He just wants an overall kind of roster review. Check it out. What am I doing right? What am I doing wrong? What should I fix? And honestly, he's got a phenomenal team. He's got some really cool characters like First Order TIE Pilot that he's using, who's a super fun character to play. Darth Nihilus, you know, he's got Shore Trooper out there, and he's got a Darth Vader lead. Now, there are a couple of things he can do to really trick this current team out, and something that's kind of exciting. And let me show you who you're going to need. I would take your Shore Trooper out, or I would take your First Order TIE Pilot out for, but I think Shore Trooper would be who I would pull for. That's right, Sith Assassin. Now, you don't have a lot of work into Sith Assassin, really just 4-star. You haven't done much else gearing her up. I think she's at 5 or 6 gear and abilities at 3. But a lot of people don't think about Darth Vader in the current meta because the Darth Maul is kind of the way of the future. But what happens is Darth Maul is on a team. A lot of people aren't using Sith Assassin. There are some Sith Assassin teams out there, but a lot more Darth Maul teams that don't have Sith Assassin. Now, Darth Maul will speed your team up, but if you have a very fast Sith Assassin under a Darth Vader, you can get your Sith Assassin to go first, provided the Maul team and the other teams you're going against do not have a Sith Assassin. And like I said, not many people use Sith Assassin right now. So if you had Sith Assassin under your Darth Vader, guess what? Darth Vader gets to go first. He gets to apply his damage over time, over everybody. And if he's going first before all those cleansing teams like Rex teams, he's going to apply the debuffs first. And then it doesn't matter how many cleanses and cleanse teams they have. They're done for because there's the debuffs over their head. And every single turn they take, they're going to be taking 2 to 3% damage every single turn to their health, and those debuffs are not going to go away. So Darth Vader, you got to get him to go quick, and the only way to make him ridiculously fast is to have an overpowered, ridiculously fast Sith Assassin. And the only way anyone could have a faster team than you is if they have a lightning fast Jedi team or a Sith Assassin underneath a Darth Maul. Both of those combinations are farther and fewer between than what you'll normally run into. So kind of a competitive edge thought process would be get your Sith Assassin geared up because that will give you a massive competitive edge with Darth Vader as your lead. So that was my thought initially on your team. I thought, you know what? He's running Darth Vader. Awesome. Pull Shore Trooper out or pull your First Order TIE Pilot out and put in Sith Assassin. She does a ton of damage. She can stun and she can speed your Sith team up significantly. Something to think about. So Sith Assassin, definitely that's what I would do. Now, as far as projects on the side, I've got about 8 individuals I would put on the side, one of which is obviously, like I always say, B2. He's just one of them side projects everybody should do, everybody should gear, and everyone should use. He's great at removing buffs, applying ability buff immunity over their head, which is phenomenal, and he puts evasion down, which is great for the evasion meta. B2, definitely he's one that I would put into your list. Number 2 is Chief Chirpa. I see that you have Chief Chirpa 6-star, but not 7-star. If you ever want to use Chief Chirpa in the heroic AAT raid with your Emperor Palpatine in Phase 3 to let Emperor Palpatine go over and over and over and over and get 1,000,000 damage or more, you're going to have Chief Chirpa's leadership ability to 7, and you're going to have him 7 stars. Also, for durability, you're probably just going to want to gear him up a little higher than where he's currently at and get some mods on him, okay? His leadership ability is great, but you do want him to be a little bit more durable than where he's at now, but you've got him just kind of sitting around. I would definitely take him as one of your side projects since you do spend some money in the game. This shouldn't be a big work for you to get him taken care of. Number 3 is Kylo Ren. You got him gear 9. keep going. Kylo Ren is a great character on offense, and he's going to help you in other areas of the game as well. So definitely would want to spend some time investing in finishing him off. So throw him in your favorites. Make him one of the eight that you're currently farming on the side. Number four is Jedi Knight Anakin. You have him at gear 8. Go ahead, put him in your favorites and start working on him. He's an excellent character, does a lot of damage, buff immunity on basic, get his attacks and abilities up. This is one of those characters. He's one of the best Jedi in the game. You definitely are going to want him to level him up for the long run. The next two, actually the next three, come out of this area, and that is Chirrut Imwe, Baze Malbus, and Wedge Antilles. You have all three of them kind of in the middle left. I would recommend you put favorite tags on all three of them and start working them. Baze and Chirrut are a phenomenal combo, and you have Biggs at gear 10. Finish Wedge. You've only got him at gear 8. You don't want him at gear 8 and Biggs at gear 10. That's just not a very usable combo, and the two of them are really overpowered together, and so is Chirrut and Baze, and you could put the four of them together with like a Darth Nihilus or a Boba Fett or someone cool, and it makes for a awesome arena team. So definitely get your Wedge up. Definitely get your Baze Malbus up. You've got him 6-star already, but your gear and attacks and abilities are only at 3. So make him a priority. Start working on him. This is really just to focus you. Chirrut, you can now farm in the ship shipments, and so continue to do that and get him up. He is viable with Baze at 3-star, but you really need to compete in arena to have them both at like gear 10 minimum for them to really be viable. Gear 9 maybe, but more likely gear 10, just to make sure they stay in. Both of them have a ton of abilities, 5 each, so there's going to be a ton of ability mats that you're going to need. That's the biggest drawback, but focus on these two characters, get them geared up, get their attacks and abilities up. Their attacks and abilities are going to matter. And so those are the last three that I would recommend. And then the last one that I mentioned earlier is, of course, Sith Assassin. Get her up with your existing Darth Vader lead. This is going to make it amazing. Cause your Darth Vader to go first most of the time. And then you'll be able to apply those debuffs over people's heads and they'll never be able to cleanse them off. Make sure that she's fast so that way she goes first, provides turn meter to your team. Darth Vader gets to go next, and boom, next thing you know, you're destroying teams left and right. So you're doing phenomenal in arena. Let's look at ships. You're doing even better in fleet arena. Your ships look great. I really think that the only thing I would do is, you know, sometimes Cassian's ship needs to be around a lot of other rebels to really be maxed out. And he's kind of on the edge of being usable at 4 stars. He's good with a great toolkit, but at 4 stars, it's really hard to keep him alive unless you have a lot of other rebels and you're choosing not to use a bunch of other rebels. Jedi Consulars a Republic, Umbarans a Republic, you know, you've got an Empire with the TIE Advance. So you might want to pull Cassian's ship out of your primary lineup. Just a thought, maybe not, but just a thought. The other thing is, I would put in the First Order TIE pilot for Jedi Consular's ship. Now, I know Jedi Consular's ship is powerful, calls and assist, yada, yada, yada. But the First Order TIE pilot is going to be able to apply target lockdown. And you currently have 2 ships that potentially do target lock. You've got your Cassian ship and your TIE Advance. But you could replace your Jedi Consular ship or your Biston ship with the First Order TIE pilot. And then in your backup, I would definitely have your Scimitar in the first backup slot, so he comes right in and gets to use his ability that called Slip Through. This ability is amazing. Definitely want to be able to use it, so put it in your first of your lineup. And then for me, I would put Jedi Consular in the second slot for durability of the end of your game. And then the third one is Slave 1. This I would have at the end to come in. By this time when he's coming in, he's going to probably be getting Admiral Ackbar's special ability where he gives everyone an additional turn, and you'll be able to do seismic charge like 2 times in a row because of that ability, which will finish whatever is on the field pretty quickly. So just a thought. Or you could switch Slave 1 and Jedi Consular in your backup and put Slave 1 in the second slot just a consideration, but definitely use slave one, scimitar, and then, but those are just ideas. You're doing really well in ships, and so just take them with a grain of salt. The only ship I see that might be a concern is your Cassian ship, and the only reason for the concern is you're not using a ton of other rebel ships. If you're going to use other rebel ships such as Biston's U-Wing and Biggs and Wedge's ships and all of that, if you're going to stack deep with all the other rebels, it makes a ton of sense to use Cassian's U-Wing. But if not, then you may want to consider using him as a backup character and putting someone else in that's just a little bit more powerful. Those are just my thoughts. But overall, Colonel 32, you're doing really, really good in arena. You're doing great in the regular arena as well. Your Darth Nihilus is probably tearing stuff up. But if you had Sith Assassin, you could potentially go first in 9 out of 10 of your battles. And that would just cause your Darth Vader to be able to get off first, which you need, especially with all of the influx of the newer Rex teams. That's how you're going to overcome those Rex teams. As always, I hope this has helped. Keep your gaming on. Warrior out.